This is another in the series of three handmade tools. How many have gone home and gone, three handmade tools when no one's looking? Try it. Anyway, so we're gonna continue on with some basic tools. Your next basic tool I'm gonna talk about is your needle. I do have to admit, because I'm doing the show, that I do buy the needles. I don't make these basic tools. I like a thicker needle when I'm throwing for cutting bigger pieces, and a smaller needle when I'm throwing for cutting smaller pieces. But also, you can make your own. A friend of mine buys a sewing kit anywhere from a darning needle to a little needle and uses a cork and just puts a needle in the cork, and then he makes his tools this way. I don't like the feel of the cork in my hand when I'm throwing. I prefer to use the pen-like shape than the cork. But you can make your own tools that way. Okay, the next we're going to talk about is the ruler. And no, I didn't make or invent the ruler, but I did make some marks on it. As you work with your ruler, production pottery, everything has to be exactly the same size. I'm forever wiping and cleaning the ruler to measure my pots, and pretty soon I've wiped all the numbers off and it's no longer a ruler, it's just a plastic stick. I found that if you are to cut where the inches are, you can see one or half one and all the way from half inch to 6 inches. And this works really well. You only have to go halfway. So if you want to measure a little bowl, your little bowl now is falling over. Your little bowl now is exactly 6 inches. But if you want to measure something more than 6 inches, okay, you already know that this is 6 inches because it's half the ruler. Now you go 6, 7, 8, 9, and the plate is 10 inches. It's a great way to measure when you're throwing or when you're finished throwing, and you don't have to worry about your measurements because they won't go away because they're cut into the ruler. Now we have our ruler, and the next thing we're going to do is how do you get your plate to be exactly that size is we use our calipers. Now I've used these for decades. This is one of my first tools I made myself. And all it is a half a hanger. Now if you imagine a hanger, it's got the other half here and the little J thing that hangs it up, upside down J. You cut it off and now you've got this wire caliper. And if you want to measure something that's, my mugs are 5.5 inches, you can go this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.5 inches. And now this is 5.5 inches tall. The nice thing is you can drop this thing, you can put it in the bucket, you can bring it back, and it's still 5.5 inches. You don't have to worry about inside measurements, you don't have to worry about outside measurements, you just have to keep a hold of this. Anyway, so there is the next in the series of three handmade tools.